This is Michael Gomez. I'm the guitar player for the band Unspoken, and I want to show you my gear. And the first thing that a lot of people never show is their cases. And this is a mono case that I love because it fits one guitar here, and it fits another guitar right over here. So if we do fly dates and stuff, and you always want to bring a backup guitar, or even when I play a Godin acoustic that's very thin, I can bring an electric and an acoustic. Boom, I'm done. In this tour, I'm just bringing two electrics. We have a short set, and I didn't see the need to bring like 800 guitars. So this guy here is one of my favorites. This is a Les Paul, I think it's 1982. And yeah, it's a standard. It's got a few cracks in the finish, which just kind of like happened by, you know, some neglecting, I guess, before it came to my hands. And I love it because it gives it so much character. Every time I post a picture of it, everybody goes just like drooling over this thing. And it's really heavy, but it plays super nice. The action's super, super low, and I love it. Simple Les Paul, they're all basically wired the same. You have tone and you have volume for the different pickup positions over here. Pickups that came in stock, and you know, normally I don't like to mess with like adding different pickups unless the guitar sounds really strange. Like I have a higher end Les Paul actually that I don't like the pickup, so probably eventually I'll switch those. But this one sound like super, super great, and I have this one a little bit lower here. They pack in a bite, so I try to keep it a little bit under control because my other guitar is like a thin line Tele style guitar. So you want to kind of like, if you switch guitars in the middle of a show, it'll be the volume difference, it'll be a bite difference. So if I'm playing this one, I normally take the overdrive a little bit less on my Kemper, which we'll go in a little bit out there. The strings, I honestly just take it to a guy in Nashville and he puts whatever. They're definitely tens. That's what I use. But the brand, I don't know. I honestly don't know what he uses. I mean, I like the Addarios, I like Elixirs and stuff, like when but I hate changing guitar strings, and I normally just pay somebody to do it for me. So right here, we have one of my favorite guitars that I've ever owned. It's yeah, it's a little sloppy up here in the top because I normally clip these things up, but this is me changing the strings. See, this is why I don't like to change strings. This is a Paler guitar. It was custom made in Louisiana by a guy named John Paler. You should follow him on Instagram because he's making insane like relic type of guitar. So it has a Duesenberg tremolo here. I believe it's got Porter pickups, and they sound amazing. I mean, this guitar is just plays super good. Sounds great. I mean, anything that I can say would be little, you know, on this guitar. So I had two of them made, same kind of finish, one Jazzmaster style, and then I got this bad boy. And but I'd say this right now is my number one go-to guitar to record and everything. I have awesome amps in my house, and I love amps more than guitars. Like I have a really nice Mr. Boogie. I had an Orange. I have a Dr. Z head. I have a Tyler amp, which is, I'm like, hands down. But I started flying a lot and doing all kinds of dates, and I couldn't bring my amps with me. So guess what? I did what a lot of people are doing. I got myself a Kemper Profiler. And so I have here my own flight case with the little wireless unit here, it's sure. And you know, so wherever I go now, like we're going to Brazil in July, I just need to bring my Kemper, and I know that my sound is gonna be exactly or very close to what I have in my ears the rest of the year. So that for me, has just created a lot of convenience without and feeling that I'm not necessarily compromising on my guitar tone, because they did an amazing job on it. And as far as like what profiles I use, I started thinking, well, I'm just gonna profile all my amps and all that. And then I talked to a couple friends of mine that said, you know what, when you buy the profiles like the Michael Britz and all the other guys that are online, these guys just like perfected that technique. They have an awesome studio, they have expensive mics. There's no way you're gonna get an awesome profile like right there in your bedroom, because I'm not necessarily like a studio guy, I'm more just like a straight up player. So I said, you know what, that sounds good. So I started digging, and I bought a bunch of profiles. Most of them are modded after an amp called Trainwreck. And then the Kemper actually has a huge and awesome effect section, because a lot of my friends have their own pedal board and they just run it and they use the Kemper as an amp. But I just decided to do a couple more days of like homework and said, hey, let me just dig in here and find all the effects and all the things and that I need, and even overdrive, stacking overdrives and things to get different tones. So I ended up just getting that thing going like that, you know? So I love it. It just has a Cat 5 that goes all the way to my pedal board, which is where we're gonna go now. I also want to talk about my in-ears. They're Westone, and they're very awesome. They isolate just about everything in the outside. And that made me, I used to bring an amp for stage volume for the Kemper, and eventually I just couldn't hear the amp because these are so isolated. So they sound awesome. They have like 18, 20 drivers. Oh, no, I'm just kidding. They have 6 drivers on each side. So they're pretty awesome. And so they're from the Kemper, this Cat 5, boom, this is all I need right now because I'm not playing. This is divided on acoustic rig and electric rig. So if I be you playing acoustic, I'm in power for this guy and this guy. But since I'm just playing this, Kemper is all there is. It's got a volume and wah controller here. And I also have a tempo board, which is amazing because I change a lot of pedals, and all I do is like on strum in the back, change them, whatever. They're super awesome, great company, check them out. This is my acoustic rig, tuner, compressor, reverb, and this is my secret weapon. This is a Candy Eye. It's got a tube inside, and it can make a crappy guitar, acoustic guitar, sounds like $1,000,000. I mean, literally every gig, somebody comes and say, hey, what's your guitar tone? And of course, I say my fingers, but then I say, yeah, so it's this guy over here. So, I love it. I hope you guys had fun checking out my gear, and thank you for your support and bringing you on tour.